first luminary female MC in this culture. And everybody got a leg up and got an influence by her. Okay, seeing her up there with all the guys. You know what I mean? It was a competitive thing with men among hip hop, much less ladies being involved. And for her to make that kind of a mark and be that influential, I think that deserves not only a round of applause, but a day like we have today. So we have the day. Let me get the round of applause for my sister, Shara. Sharrock's influence has transcended her early days as a gypsy B-girl, a wandering B-girl, she calls herself. She went from every place there was hip-hop, any place there was music, any place there was dancing, she went. Anywhere there was a B-boy or B-girl scene, she went or created one, okay? And then on the mic with the original Funky Four, later on the Funky Four plus one more, being the first hip-hop group to appear on national television, 1980, Saturday Night Live. Make some noise for that. Give it up, give it up. A lot of us have been around for a long time. And a lot of us have contributed to this culture in one way or another. Some greater, some less. But Sharrock's contributions are undeniable, and they stand to this day. And as a testament to females in hip hop, like Nicki Minaj and Megan Thee Stallion and Cardi B and all the others who precede them all the way down, all that starts with our sister, Sharrock. So when I count to three, I need everybody in this park, everybody within the sound of my voice, to say loud and clear, Sharrock. Sister, like I said, we are on Rock the Bells Radio Monday through Friday on Sirius XM channel 43. Our show is called That's the Joint, okay? And that's only right. And if you're not tuned in, make sure you tune in, all right? So right about now, I want to bring to the stage another co-host, another female that's surely been influenced and empowered by Sharrock's legacy, Deborah Coco. Give it up for Deborah Coco, y'all.
Hey, Coco. I love the name Coco. It's so sweet. Hey, Coco.
Ooh, I think I put my plate down.
What's up?
I was a B-boy for a while. But you can't walk up to a girl and answer the dance and then start doing windmills. That shit don't work. So I gravitated toward the turntables, and this is back in 1974. You know what I mean? I lived up the block from DJ Kool Herc, who we recognize as the father of hip hop, and followed that example as a DJ, and kind of took the steps. And at the end of the day, from Casanova Fly to CASN to OVAN, the rest is FLY. To Grandmaster Caz, the legendary Cold Crush Brothers, and the legacy continues. So I just want to thank you guys for the recognition. I love y'all and I appreciate y'all, especially my sister, my partner, Sharrock. I can't say it enough. Thank you, baby.
Broke off and started the Cold Crush Brothers with my brothers, AD, Grandmaster Caz, T-Bone is in the crowd. A couple of us are here. I just want to say thank you. I'm in the Smithsonian, a couple of us in the Smithsonian. But I have my exhibit in the Smithsonian on the third floor. It's about half the basketball court. So when you go to the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C., it's on the third floor. Thank you, peace and love.
Good.
the infamous DXT doing his own shit. He owns the rights to this music, not me.